Lao Tze was a student of the great master Lao Tze, he who initiated the I Ching. One day, Lao Tze met his master Lao Tze as Lao Tze was on the road to the city of Wei. Now, as was said the other day, Wei has a very significant meaning in Chinese. So one time, it would be wise to look up the word Wei. But in their meeting, Lao Tze looked at Lao Tze in the eyes, and then he raised his eyes to heaven and let out a deep sigh. And Lao Tze said to Lao Tze, "I had thought at a certain time that you were eminently teachable. But now I can see there is no possibility that you can be taught." But Lao Tze remained silent, but he followed Lao Tze on the road. And Lao Tze came to an inn where he was to stay for the night. When they entered the inn, Lao Tze took a bowl and a towel and filled the bowl with water, handed them to his master with a comb. And then he waited while Lao Tze went through his ablutions. And then he waited while Lao Tze had a repast at the inn. And when this was completed and Lao Tze had sat down in silence, Lao Tze humbly approached him and said, "Master, I did not want to disturb you whilst you were on the road, nor did I want to disturb you whilst you were partaking of your meal and having your ablutions. But please, now that you seem to be a little free, would you tell me what it is that I've done wrong?" Lao Tze looked at Lao Tze and he said, "You are arrogant, you are haughty, and you have no respect for anything." Lao Tze said to Lao Tze, "Please, Master, will you guide me?" Lao Tze said to Lao Tze, "Those who are virtuous do not believe they have virtue, and those who are enlightened do not appear to be perfect. It is only when you are in this state that you can transcend life and yet still be a part of life." Now Lao Tze felt that he had been whacked with Lao Tze's staff, and a change took place in him. When he entered that inn, the innkeeper treated him with great respect. The innkeeper's wife fell over herself trying to serve him. And when he sat down at the table to eat, the other patrons kept a respectful distance and spoke quietly so as not to disturb him. But when he left that inn, the innkeeper was laughing and joking with him. The innkeeper's wife gave him sweetmeats to take on his travels. And the other patrons fell over themselves, seeking to sit at his table and keep him company. What does this story mean? Get its deep meaning for each of us. How do we relate to life now? How does life relate to us? If we put ourselves outside ourselves and see the way that others look at us, in this place of stillness and silence and emptiness, are you like the master up on the mountain who sits in silence, his presence so awesome that you hardly dare approach him, and when you do, you quake in your boots? Here we are in life, ordinary, having to relate to life, having to do the things that one does, to put bread on the table, how do you relate to life, and how does life relate to you? What does it mean when we are virtuous, we do not believe that we have virtue? And when we're enlightened, we do not appear. What is the change that took place in Lao Tze? One moment, life keeping him at a distance in awe, and the next moment falling over itself to be part of his company.
Because before he felt himself above him, above all the people, and looking for a way out of the world, and then afterwards he felt one with everything, with everyone.
Yes. Yes. How does it happen? When we answer the question, what is the meeting place between stillness and movement? In that moment, the change takes place.